Hi students, welcome to the second video on machine independent macroprocessor features. So you already studied concatenation of macro parameters and generation of unique labels, and in this video I would like to discuss about conditional macro expansion and keyword macro parameters. So first one is conditional macro expansion. Macroprocessors can also modify the sequence of statements generated for a macro expansion depending on the argument supplied in the macro invocation. So I'll try to explain with the help of an example. Here I have an example whose macro name is M1 and argument is condition. So when this macro is invoked, either part 1 or part 2 of the macro of this macro will get expanded. If the condition is true, the part 1 will get expanded, otherwise part 2 will get expanded. That is conditional macro expansion. Okay, based on the argument, the condition will be checked. If the condition is true, what will happen? Part 1 will be expanded. If condition is false, part 2 will be expanded. So here, what's the condition? Condition any means not equal to null. So similarly, any, we have any for not equal to, eq for equal to, le for less than or equal to, gt for greater than. Similarly, we have other compare operators also. So this is conditional macro expansion. So based on the argument value, some part of the macro will get expanded. So a subtopic is there, which is called macro time variables. Macro time variables begins with ampersand, but is not a macro instruction parameter. We already studied in macro, if something is starting by ampersand, it is macro instruction parameter. But here, what is macro time variable? Anything which starts with ampersand, but it is not a macro instruction parameter. Can be used to store working values during the macro expansion. Controls the macro time conditional structures. Auto initialized to a value 0. Values are set by macroprocessor directly set. So in this example, here EORCK is a macro time variable. It is not a macro instruction parameter. Since it is starting by ampersand, it is a macro time variable. Initial value of this macro time variable is 1. It is stored or it is initialized using the macro processor directive set. So you just compare this macro time variable with our loop variable. Loop variable means earlier some we have studied for I equals 0, I less than and some I plus plus. Then I is the loop variable. So similarly, we have macro time variable. So we'll try to explain macro time conditional statements with the help of an example. So here I have a macro. What's the macro name? RDBuf. Here we have some parameters. 5 parameters are there. So here I have a macro invocation. RDBuf, F3, buf, RECL, 42048. So what is given here? If ampersand EOR not equal to null. What is EOR here? EOR here is 4. So it is not equal to null. What is this EORCK? It is a macro time variable. It is initialized as 1. Endif. That means if this condition is true, the macro time variable EORCK will be set as 1. Next, what happens? ClearX. So ClearX will be copied to expanded program. Clear A will be copied to expanded program. Then what's the condition? If EORCK equal to 1. Anyway, EORCK is equal to 1 since we already set its value as 1. So LDCH X ampersand EOR. In place of EOR, what will be there? The 04 will be there because the value of EOR here is 4. Then RMO A comma S will be copied. End if. So this if condition is closed. Another if condition is there. If max length equal to null. What is max length here? Max length is 2048. So this condition is false. So what will happen? This line number 47 will be copied to expanded program. Plus LDT. What is the value of max length? This 2048. Max length 2048. Max length 2048. So it is also another end if. So this if statement is closed. Here this condition is false. So 45 is not copied to expanded program, and numbers 47 is copied. Similarly, this TDX INDV instead of INDV, what happens? That F3 is copied. Again, URC equal to 1. Then these two statements will be copied. URCK is already set as 1. So those things will be copied. Compare AS and JEQ A exit. This is the first example. So based on the condition, certain statements are copied to expanded program. In earlier examples we studied, all the statements are copied. Here if the condition satisfies, that statements which comes under that condition will be copied to expanded program. We will look another example. Same macro but different invocation. Here we just examine value of EOR is null. Value of EOR is actually null. So what will happen if ampersand EOR not equal to null? Anyway, this condition is false. So this macro time variable will not be set. Clear X will be copied, clear A will be copied if ampersand EOR CK equal to 1 is false. So these two statements will not be copied. 40 and 42 will not be there in the expanded program. Then again, an if condition is there if max length EQ null. Anyway, max length is 80 here, so it is not equal to null. So plus LDT hash 80 will be there in the expanded program. It is there in the line number 47. Then this line number 50 will be there, 55 will be there, 60 will be there. The macro time label is AB because it is the second invocation. In the previous video we have already discussed about labels in macro, how labels are handled. Here it is AB because it is second invocation. The first example we have studied the first invocation. Again, there is a condition if EOR CK EQ1, this condition is false because it is not set as 1. So 65 and 70 will not be there in the expanded program. Again, 75 will be there, 80 will be there, then 85 is also there, JLT $AB loop, 90 is also there. This is another example where the value of EOR is null. This is the third example. I think if you are familiar with first two examples, you can easily understand this third one also. Next one is macro time looping statements. In earlier three examples, we have studied if and else. If and else. Here it is looping statement. Here the looping statement is actually while. In 64, we have a while condition. In 64, we have a while condition. Before that, we just look at the parameters. RDBuf, F2, buffer length. Then something is given in bracket again. 00, 03, 04. Actually, this is a list. Just imagine this as a list. What is line number 27? EORCT set percentage n items ampersand EOR. The meaning is n items count number of elements in the list. EOR is a list. We already discussed EOR is a list. So it just counts the number of items in the EOR. So EORCT will be set as 3 because here we have 3 elements. So clear X will be copied, clear A will be copied, this plus LDT 4096 will be copied. Here we have a loop, so AA loop, TDX ampersand INDEV, INDEV is F2, so in line number 50 here we get F2, then JEQ $AA loop, RD equal to X ampersand INDEV, in place INDEV we have F2, CTR is a macro time variable, it is set as 1. While CTR less than or equal to EORCT. What's the value of EORCT? We already noticed your value of EORCT is 3. And here CTR value is 1. 1 is less than 3. So it is true. So you just look at this while loop. How many statements are inside this while loop? While loop ends at NW. NW means end of while loop. In this while loop we have 3 statements. So when this condition is true, these 3 statements will be executed. Anyway, this condition is true now. COMB equal to X, some 4 zeros followed by ampersand EOR CTR. What's the value of CTR? The initial value of CTR is 1. EOR of 1. We already studied EOR. EOR is a list. So EOR of 1 means first element in the list. What is the first element of the list? 00. So here I got COMB, some four zeros followed by these two zeros. Actually, these two zeros are these two zeros from the list. Then JEQ dollar exit. So dollar exit will be replaced by dollar AA exit. We already studied how labels are handled in macros. Then CTR is set as CTR plus 1. Now the value of CTR is 1. So it is incremented by 1. Now CTR becomes 2. Again this while loop will be tested. 2 less than or equal to 3. Again the condition is true. So COMB X 4 zeros followed by EOR of 2. EOR of 2 means second item in the list. What is the second item in the list? 03. This is how I got 03 here. Similarly, the loop will execute again. CTR becomes 3. 3 less than or equal to 3 is also true. So again the third item will be there. Third item will be fetched from the list. That is 04. This is how this line number 65 is generated. So 4 zeros followed by a 04. So what happens here? Earlier we studied if and else. Here we studied loop. The while loop. We all know the working of while loop. And in this example we have 3 statements in the while loop. And whenever the condition is true, these 3 statements will be repeatedly copied in expanded program. So I hope you understood macro time looping statements. So next one is keyword macro parameters. So parameters and arguments are associated according to the positions in macro prototype and invocation. We already studied this point in the initial videos. If an argument is omitted, a null argument should be used to maintain the proper order in macro invocation. We already saw an example about this one here. Actually in the parameter UR is there, but in the argument it is missing. So it is given by a null value. So in this example I have a macro M1 and it have 4 parameters. The first invocation I am using only 3 arguments. The second argument is missing. That means the value of P2 is null. So if an argument is to omitted, a null argument should be used to maintain the proper order in macro invocation. So the order of parameters and argument must be maintained. So another invocation M1 is there. Here I have only one argument. This X4 corresponding to parameter P4. So in keyword parameter, each argument value is written with a keyword that names the corresponding parameter. Arguments may appear in any order. In macro prototype, each parameter name is followed by an equal sign which identifies a keyword parameter. Default values can be specified in the prototype itself. So these points will be explained with the help of an example. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parameters are there. So this F1 is the default value for INDEV. That means in this macro invocation, if the value of INDEV is not specified, it is taken as F1. The default value of buffer ADR is null. The default value of record length RECLTH is null. The default value of EOR equal to 04. The default value of max length is 4096. So you can specify default values of parameter in the macro prototype itself with the help of an equal to symbol. So here there is a macro invocation. Here we have only 2 parameters. Buff ADR equal to buffer, RECLTH is equal to length. So what will be the value of INDEV in this one? It will be F1. Here INDEV is not specified, so it will take the default value. Here UR is not specified, so it will take the default value. Max length is not specified, so it will take the default value for 4096. So this macro is actually expanded based on those values. So in place of INDEV, we will get F1, line number 50. You just compare line number 50 of both the programs. Program on the left hand side and on the right hand side. Similarly, compare the value of EOR. Here we have EOR, the line number 40. It is replaced by 04. So keyword macro parameters means along with the parameter, the default values are also specified. One more example is there. So in the earlier we studied, these parameters or arguments are based on positional notation. So here in the macro invocation itself, the parameters are also specified. RECLTH. RECLTH is actually the third parameter in the macro prototype, but here when I invoked it, I have used it as first. So what's the meaning? If we are specifying macro parameters in the invocation, there is no need to maintain the order of parameters and arguments. Here actually INDV is F1, default value is F1, but in this invocation it is F3. That's why in the expanded program, in place of INDV it is F3. So here actually the default value is F1, but the value in the invocation is F3. So here the value will be F3. RECLTH, there is no default value, here it is given as length. Actually UR is default value is 04, here UR value is null. So it is expanded according to that, UR not equal to null, this will be false, so URCK will be false. So this condition is also false since 27 is not executed. So this 40 and 42 will not be there. So we just closely go through these examples. So this is all about machine independent macro processor features. Thank you.